Hello and welcome to the Skyvia tutorials. In this video, we will check how to sync data between Snowflake and SQL Server. This tutorial assumes that you already have a Skyvia account. If you don't have it yet, you can create it for free by following the link in the description. Before you start building integration between SQL Server and Snowflake, create a connection to each of them. To create a new connection to SQL Server, click Create New and select Connection. Skyvia is compatible with a variety of databases and data warehouses, including BigQuery, Redshift, MySQL, Postgres, Azure, and many others. Choose SQL Server. There are two ways to create a connection to SQL Server, directly or through the agent. Choose a direct connection if your database is accessible over the internet. To set up a direct connection, enter the server's address, your user ID, password, and select the database you want to connect to. If your SQL Server is on a local computer or network, use the agent connection. Agent application will act as a secure layer between Skyvia and your database server. To connect through the agent, first download the agent app. Click Create New, select Agent, then download and install the app on your computer. On this page, you'll see your agent's key. Copy it to paste into the agent app's UI once it's running, or download it and place it in the same folder as the agent app so the key is inserted automatically. It's also recommended to rename your agent for easy identification in the future. After downloading and installing the agent app, you're ready to create a new connection. Select Agent Connection mode at the top, choose your agent from the dropdown, and enter the server's IP address, user ID, password, and the database to connect to. Remember to keep the agent app running while using this connection. If the app doesn't launch properly, right-click on it and select Run as Administrator. To create a new connection to Snowflake, click Create New, select Connection, and choose Snowflake. Enter the domain, user, password, and database. The warehouse, schema, and role fields are optional, however, they are required for replication and import integrations that we will cover shortly. The last field is files storage for bulk. Snowflake uses a fast data importing and processing method where data is first loaded into temporary file storage as CSV files and then processed by Snowflake's computing power. You can choose between Amazon S3 and Azure storage. If none is selected for the file storage for bulk, you can still import data between SQL Server and Snowflake, but replication to Snowflake won't be available and data processes will be slower. Once done with the connections, let's move to replication. Replication creates a copy of your SQL Server database on Snowflake's data warehouse. This can be useful, for example, if you want to offload data from SQL Server to Snowflake for advanced analytics. This example will cover replicating a custom-created ERP. To replicate your data, click Create New and choose Replication. Select SQL Server as source and Snowflake as target. Let's start with replication options. If you want to track changes instead of replicating the whole database every run, leave incremental updates enabled. Select the Update Schema checkbox to apply data structure changes made in the source to the database schema in target. If incremental updates are enabled, you will need to choose an ingestion mode. Select New and Modified to replicate both new and modified records. Select New to only replicate new records, ignoring updates to previously replicated records. Select Log Base to use the native database change tracking mechanism to locate new and modified records. You can also choose to create or drop tables. Now, select SQL Server tables. By default, all object fields are replicated. If you want to replicate specific columns only or tune the settings for some table, click Edit. In the Task Editor window, you can change the object replication behavior. To rename the target object, change the target name field. To define a replication behavior, select one of three modes. Standard mode is assigned to each object automatically and uses the settings of your replication. Resync mode forces the full replication of the object by dropping and creating an object in target during each integration run. Resync on demand is created for objects that are part of your replication but are not required for each replication run. With resync on demand, you can include the object in the next replication run by resetting its last sync time. Ingestion mode defines how to track changes in source during incremental replication. Depending on the ingestion mode, created column and modified column fields will appear. If you need to filter data, add conditions. Once you're done, click Save Task. Now you can run or schedule the integration. Click Schedule to set it up for future runs. You can set the integration to run every day or on specific weekdays, every few hours or minutes, and achieve near real-time data integration. Let's schedule integration to run every day at 10 a.m. Rename your integration by editing the Untitled field. Click Create to save your integration. To start the replication process immediately, click the Run button. After starting the replication, you can check the execution status and its results on the monitor and log tabs, where you'll see the number of successfully replicated rows and error messages in case something goes wrong. Let's move to the next scenario, syncing Snowflake data to SQL Server. In this example, we will sync sales orders from Snowflake to the SQL Server database using Import, a wizard-based ETL tool that allows users to integrate data in any direction. Import is ideal for scenarios such as migrating data between platforms, synchronizing data across systems, and performing ETL or reverse ETL processes to move data into cloud applications or databases. To create a new import, click Create New and select Import. In the source type, select Data Source. Select Snowflake as source and SQL Server as target. To define the data to load, its destination, and how to map it, click Add New. You can add any number of tasks to your import integration. On the Source Definition page, select the source object to import data from. You can also apply filters to your data. For example, let's exclude one of the products. To do this, add the filter condition. Click the Next Step button. Select the target object and choose the operation. Use Insert to add new records, Update to modify existing ones, and Delete to remove records. The Upsert operation updates a record if it exists or inserts a new one. The next step is mapping. Skyvia tries to map fields automatically. However, you can remap any field as you see fit. There are four mapping types: colon, constant, lookup, and expression. To use Upsert, you need to map the primary key using lookup. Lookup mapping fetches a value for the mapped target field from a record in any source or target object based on specific conditions. After mapping the fields, click Save Task. Let's review import options. You can enable Preserve Task Order to execute the tasks in the order they appear in the task list. The Nested Objects checkbox allows you to unwind fields, store nested objects or arrays, and access or map the fields within these nested structures. Enable the Source Values in Error Log checkbox to see the source data in the logs. If everything is correct, change the name in the Untitled field and click Create to save the integration. Let's run this import integration. The Monitor tab shows the details of the import to SQL Server. You can also set up notifications about integration errors. Click on your user account icon and select Account Settings. Choose Notifications in the menu and select which emails should receive a notification. If your scheduled integration fails, you will receive an email. For more complex scenarios with complicated logic, advanced transformations, or several connectors at once, Skyvia offers Dataflow, a visual ETL data pipeline designer. In this example, we will walk through a data flow that imports orders into different SQL Server tables, depending on the order quantity. To create a data flow, click Create New and select Data Flow. This data flow imports orders from Snowflake to different SQL Server tables based on the order quantity. This flow has four components: source, condition, targets, and variables. The source component queries data from Snowflake. The condition component checks whether the order quantity is greater or equals 5. If true, the data is routed to the wholesale table. If the quantity is less than 5, the orders will be inserted into the order sales table. You can add more conditions if needed. The row count components track how many rows were successfully imported into the target tables and how many failed. You can also count the number of rows directed to each target by adding new values in the results section. Thank you for watching this SQL Server and Snowflake integration tutorial. If you have any additional questions, feel free to drop us a comment below and we will help you. To try Skyvia for free, use the link in the description. See you in the next videos.